Welcome to this session of Materials Engineering. Today we will discuss the average number of atom per unit cell, coordination number, atomic packing factor, and how to calculate atomic packing factor for various crystalline material we will discuss today. So first of all, from the last session we have discussed about that Miller indices and its directions, and what are the features of an crystalline material, and for most important things, that is common crystalline materials and with their property, that we have discussed. And today we will discuss elaborately about that fact. So first of all, that is average number of atoms per unit cell. So first of all, we know that various type of crystal structure, average atoms per unit cell can be calculated. In cubic structure, the corner atoms are shared by 8 cells, as we have already discussed in the last session. Face atoms shared by 2 cells, 2 adjacent cells, and atoms at the interiors are shared by only 1 cell. So in general, it can be written, that is N, here capital N, average, that is number of atom average in an unit cell, crystal in a cubical cell, that is NC by 8 plus NF by 2 plus NI by 1, where N average, that is NAV, that is average number of atom per unit cell, NC total number of corner atoms in an unit cell, NF total number of face atom in an unit cell, and NI center or interior atom. Using the above equations, we can find average number of atom per unit cell. So first of all, that is simple cubic structure. So as we can see the figure of the simple cubic structure, as see that there are 8 corner atoms are there, 8 corner atoms, and there are no face atom and there is no atom at the interior of the cell. So we can calculate from this equation, that is 8 corner atoms, that is NC is equal to 8, and there is no face atom and interior atom, so as this part will be 0. Now using this equation, the average number of atom per unit cell in a simple cubic structure, we can calculate, that is 1. So 1, that is, although that cell is consist of, that is 8 corner atoms only, but the average number of atoms per unit cell, that is 1. Next, that is very important structure, that is body centered cubic structure. In a body centered cubic structure, as we see that there are 8 corner atoms and 1 atom at the interior, that is center of the unit cell, that is NC is equal to 8 and there is no face atom, so NF equal to 0 and NI is equal to 1. Now again we can see the figure. So this is the example of body centered cubic. As we can see, there are 8 corner atoms are there and 1 atom at the interior. So there are NC value will be 8 and NF here 0, that means there is no face atoms are there, and interior NI, that will be 1. So we can calculate by using equation number 1, that is N average equal to NC by 8 plus NF by 2 and NI by 1, so that is equal to 2. So here we can see that average number of atom per unit cell in a body centered cubic structure, that will be 2. Now next, another important crystal structure, that is face centered cubic structure. Now in this structure there are 8 corner atoms, 6 atoms at the center of face, and there is no interior atom. So therefore NC is equal to 8, NF is equal to 6, and NI is equal to 0. As we can see the figure, so this figure is the face centered cubic. As we can see, this is the face centered cubic. So there are 8 corner atoms are there, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 faces in a cubical structure. So there are 6 face atoms are there, which is shared by 2 adjacent cells. So for calculation, that is NC is equal to 8 and NF is equal to 6. So by using this equation, we can find out that average number of atom per unit cell, that will be 4. So in a face centered cubic structure, average number of atoms per unit cell, that will be 4. Although that cell consists of 8 plus 6, that means total 14 number of atoms are there in that crystal. But the equivalent number of atoms, that will be equal to 4 from this equation. Now for another type of crystal structure, which is very important, and it is not a cubical structure, this is hexagonal closed pack structure. In short, it is known as HCP structure. In hexagonal structure, the corner atoms are shared by 6 cells. Face atoms are shared by 2 cells. And atoms are interior are shared by only 1 cell. So in general, the equation for hexagonal structure, it will be like this. That is, average equal to NC by 6, NF by 2, and NI by 1. Where again NC, the total number of corner atom in an unit cell, NF, total number of face atom in an unit cell, and NI, center or the interior atoms. Now as we can see the figure of an hexagonal closed pack, as we see, so there are 6 atoms are there. Now we have to change the color. We are changing the color here, taking as green. So you see that there are total 6 atoms are there at faces, at one face. So 2 face are there, so total will be 12 face atom. 12 corner atom, not face atom. There are 6 corner atom at bottom face, and in upper face there are again 6 corner atoms are there. So there are total 12 atoms are there, 12 corner atoms are there, and in two face atoms are there, that is upper and bottom face, 2 face atoms are there. And in an interior, there are 3 atoms are there, 3 whole atoms are there. So we can calculate the average number of atom per unit cell for this hexagonal structure. So there are total 12 corner atoms, 6 at bottom face and 6 at top face, 2 atoms at the center of the above 2 faces, and 3 atoms at the interior of the unit cell. So thus it gives NC is equal to 12, NF 2, and NI is equal to 3. So now using this equation for an hexagonal closed pack structure, so we can find this one, that is the average number of atom per unit cell it will be 6 hexagonal close pack. Although there are total 17 atom constitutes a hexagonal close pack structure, but equivalent to 6 atoms are there in an unit cell. Now next is coordination number. Now what is coordination number? Coordination number or density of packing is the term nearest equidistant neighboring atoms surrounding an atom under consideration. In general, less the coordination number, less is the packing factor. So density of packing is expressed in terms of number of nearest adjacent neighboring atoms surroundings and atoms under consideration. This number is called coordination number. That means in a crystalline structure, in an atom, the number of surrounding atoms are there. Nearest number of surrounding atoms are there, which are in equidistance, neighboring atom. So the number of atoms surroundings with equidistance neighboring atom, that is known as the coordination number. So in general, less the coordination number, less is the packing factor. So in case of simple cubic structure, each corner atom is surrounded by six other atoms, and hence the coordination number is 6 in this structure. In body-centered cubic, each corner atoms is surrounded by 8 other centered atom, and hence the coordination number is 8 in this structure. In closed packed structure such as HCP and FCC, the total number of equidistant neighbors are 12 irrespective of the method of stacking of the plane. Hence the nearest equidistant neighboring atom surrounding atom, that is coordination number for FCC and HCP structure, is 12. In ionic solids, the bonds are non-directional and hence promotes more close packing of the structure. Hence coordination number, which is also known as ligancy, is the number of anions surrounding a central cation. This ligancy is a function of ion size and can be found out by space filling geometry when other conditions for stable configurations are satisfied. The possible value of ligancy and the range of, that is RC by RA ratio, that is RC, that is radius of cation by radius of anion ratio for stable configurations, are some fixed values are there, and it is given by the next slide. So in this slide showing possible values of ligancy and range, that is RC by RA ratio for a stable configuration, which is in case of ionic solids. Now if we consider ligancy 2, the range of RC by RA ratio varies from 0 to 0.155, and the configuration of the structure will be linear. If ligancy 3, the value of RC by RA varies from 0.155 to 0.225, and in this case the configuration will be triangular. If ligancy 4, the range RC by RA varies from 0.225 to 0.414, and configuration it will be tetrahedral. If ligancy will be 6, the range of RC by RA will be 0.414 to 0.732, and the configuration will be octahedral. If ligand C 8, the range of RC by RA will be 0.732 to 1.0, and configuration will be cubical. And if ligand C is 12, the range of RC by RA value will be 1, and the configuration will be FCC or HCP structure. Now note that ligand C 5, 7, 9, 10 and 11 do not satisfy the condition for a stable configuration for any value of the radius ratio, and hence they do not appear. Now we have to solve some problem, very basic problem of this ionic, that is coordination number of the ionic solids. First problem, it is given the ionic radius of an anion is 2.11 angstrom. Find the radius of the smallest cation that can have stable 8-fold coordination with the above anion. So how to solve this one? The range of, that is RC by RA for 8-fold coordination is given. That is from the table, we have to consider this table, that is ligand C value 8. Here we can see that ligand C value 8. The ligand C value 8. Ligand C value 8. As we can see, so this 8-fold configuration, ligand C value 8. The smallest cation we have to find out. So 8-fold coordination, that is varies from 0.732 to 1 from table 1, as we can see. This one. That is 0.732 to 1.0, the range of RC by RA. So now, therefore, the radius of smallest cation can be calculated. RC by RA is equal to 0.732. So we have to take the minimum of this. Now it is given that radius of anion, that is 2.11 angstrom, and RC by RA for the smallest cation, that is 0.732. So therefore RC is equal to 0.732 into RA, that is 0.732 into 2.11, so that will give us 1.545 angstrom. This will be the answer. That is the smallest cation, that will be 1.545 angstrom. Now another question of similar type. It is given the chloride ion has a radius of 0.181 nanometer. Calculate the radius of smallest cation which can be coordinated with 8 neighboring chloride ions. So chloride ion has a radius of 0.181 nanometer, and calculate the radius of smallest cation which can be coordinated with 8 neighboring chloride ion. So in this case, in this problem, radius of anion, that is chloride ion, that is given, that is 0.181 nanometer. which is equal to 10 angstrom, and the ligancy is 8, and for the stable 8-fold coordination number, the radius of cation, that is the ratio RC by RA, we know from the table, that is 0.7322, it varies from 0.732 to 1.0. Now for the smallest radius of cation, we have to take the least value, that is 0.732, and therefore we can find very easily what is the radius of cation, that is RA into 0.732, ultimately it will give 0.132 nanometer or 1.32 angstrom. So these two are very basic problem from this coordination number. Next we will move to the atomic packing factor, which is very important from the subject point of view. Atomic packing factor is defined, that is the fractional amount of volume or space occupied by atom in an unit cell, called atomic packing factor, that is APF, or atomic packing density or efficiency. Therefore, APF is equal to volume of atoms in unit cell by volume of unit cell. Now, we can see that volume of atom in a unit cell, we can find out average number of atoms per unit cell. We have seen this part, that is average number of atoms per unit cell, into volume of an atom and divided by volume of the unit cell. So the atomic packing factor of the cubic and HCP structures can be calculated as below. Now this atomic packing factor is very important property in material science or engineering materials, and we need to find out that how much occupancy of the atom in an unit cell. So for a simple cubic structure, the figure is shown here. For the simple cubic structure, we know there are 4 and 4, that is total 8 corner atoms are there. And if we consider an unit cell, so this will be look like, that is not total number of atom that is completely shared by in an unit cell, a fraction of corner atoms are shared in an unit cell, if we consider in this way. So because in the upper stack, in the lower stack, side stack and various face stack, there are some other unit cells which are again shared by the same atom. So if we calculate only one particular unit cell, so the figure will be look like this. So as if the atoms are fractionally, that is distributed. So in a simple cubic structure, the atoms are assumed to be placed in such a way that any two adjacent atoms touch each other. This is the condition, that in a simple cubic structure, that is the atoms are assumed to, that is they are closely packed each other, that is two adjacent atoms are in such a way they are, the atoms are touch with other. So as we can see in this figure, that this figure, the four atoms are touched each other, and also the lower atoms are also touched with the atoms. So all the atoms are closely packed to each other, and they forming this simple cubic structure. Now if A is the lattice parameter, that means we are considering that cubic and HCP structure in a cubical system, that is arm lengths A, B and C, if we consider, so all are equal, and if we consider, that is A is the lattice parameter of the cubical structure, and in this case of simple cubic structure, and R is the radius of the atom. So now it is clear from the figure that this r, that is small r, radius of an one atom will be equal to a by 2. Why? Because these atoms are shared two adjacent atoms are shared and they are touch with other. So it is clear from the figure that if the lattice parameter A is given and the relation between the radius R with the lattice parameter A, it will be that R is equal to A by 2. Now we can calculate the APF, that is atomic packing factor. From the definition we know that is average number of atoms per cell into volume of an atom by volume of the unit cell. So average number of atoms per cell, as we know, for this simple cubic structure it will be 1, and volume of an atom we considered that it is an hard sphere, that is atom we have considered for simplicity that it is a hard sphere, and its volume for an hard sphere, the volume is 4/3 pi r cube, r is the radius, and volume of the unit cell, that will be for this cubical structure, it will be a cube. So from this relation that is r is equal to a by 2, so we are considering that is a is equal to 2r cube, 2r to the power 3, that is a is equal to 2r. So now we are replacing all of this, and by calculating all of this we find it that is for a simple cubic structure the APF value is 0.52. that means the 52% of these structures are occupied by the atom and remaining portions are vacant. Now we will move to the next part, that is very very important from the subject point of view, that is body centered cubic or BCC structure. So a BCC structure, if we consider only one BCC crystals, so we see that we know there are 8 corner atoms and there are 1 interior atoms are there fully in the structure, BCC structure. So as we can see, the fractional amount of corner atoms are shown by this figure, and here is the geometry that we can see. So we are considering the total length of this, that is this length will be r, this will be the 2r in the interior atom, and again it will be r. So if a is the lattice parameter of the BCC structure and r is the radius of the atom, so we have to find the relationship between these two, that is r and a, and it can be written as we know from this figure, that is df we considered, that is dg plus gf square. So dg plus gf square, so gf is very easy to all of us, that is gf is nothing but the a again. Now dg square, again we can see the dg square from the geometry, we can write dc square plus cg square, and df is equal to 4r as we can see from this figure. Now df square is equal to dc square cg square plus gf square, which is equal to 4r square equal to a square plus a square plus a square, that means 3a square. So the relation between the r, that is radius of the atom, and lattice parameter A relation is we can calculate, that is R is equal to A root over 3 by 4 by calculation. Now we can find what is the APA value, that is atomic packing factor from definition, that is average number of atoms per unit cell into volume of an atom by volume of the unit cell. So average number of atom per unit cell from the earlier one, that is average number of atom for BCC structure, we know that is there are two number of atom. One is interior atom and eight corner atoms are shared by the cell. So that will be NC, that is NC by 8, NF by 2 and NI by 1 for a cubical structure. And in this case, total 8 atoms are there. So 8 by 8, 1 and interior 1 atom. So there will be total 2 atoms are there. So there will be 2 atoms are there, 2 atoms. And the volume of an atom, as it is a hard sphere, as we have considered, that is 4/3 pi r cube. And this r value, we can replace this by this relation, that is r is equal to a root over 3 by 4 and volume of the unit cell is a cube. So by calculating, we can see that APA for an BCC structure, that is body centered cubic structure, is 0.68. That means 68% of this structure are occupied by the atom and remaining are vacant. Now for example, some of the metals having BCC structure at room temperature is given, that is for example it is given, that is iron, metal iron, that is lattice constant A in nanometer, it is given 0.287 and atomic radius 0.124. Chromium 0.289 and atomic radius 0.125. Sodium lattice constant A 0.429 and atomic radius R given 0.186 nanometer. So thus the various type of metals are there at room temperature. We can see the BCC structure, that is tungsten, vanadium, molybdenum, etc. are there. So we will conclude this session, and next session we will discuss the other APF structure, that is FCC and FCC HCP structure, FCC and HCP structure, and the how to calculate the density of the that is called density calculation of the material. So thank you for joining this session.